stopped listening to music. Now, I just want to say, 1 out of 100 times, as in not often, but maybe once every 3 months, I'll listen to an actual song. But besides that point, I stopped listening like to music because everyone listens to music. So it's like a social norm to listen to music. When I first discovered subliminals, I tried them for 3 days. I didn't see any results, so I gave up. And then for about 6 months, after 6 months, I went back to them because I found out about visual subliminals. So I said, maybe I should go back to auditory subliminals. And then eventually I found more physical subliminals, and I started making them. So I eventually developed the type of mindset, why would I listen to any mainstream song if it's not going to have any positive results on me? You listen to a song about smoking 100 times, you're going to smoke. Because people's subconscious absorbs subliminal messages. Every single song you listen to, whether it's positive or negative, has messages in it. Your subconscious picks those messages up. It creates a new brain synapse. Those are the connectors in your brain, the neurons travel through them. You're going to create a new one, a new brain synapse, just for that song. Your brain is amazing. It's got thousands of synapses transmitting. The more you listen to that one certain song, for years you'll remember it after. Not only that, you'll do some of the things that are mentioned in the song. You listen to music about feeling depressed, down, sad, unhappy. What are you going to feel? All those things. Because you're encouraging a certain life. That's why I listen to subliminals. That's why I watch subliminals. Because they actually give me something out of listening. You know, an iPhone gives off as much radiation as a working microwave. It goes, well, because they have those devices that measure radiation. It goes well over the tipping point of the amount that your body can actually handle. So if you have headphones in your ears for, we'll say, 6 hours, you may likely give yourself a seizure, even if you don't have epilepsy. Not that I'm saying that will happen. I'm saying it's possible because you're overstimulating your mind and you're feeding it radiation. You'll know when your skin starts getting feeling dry and flaky and you start getting more acne. And you're thinking, why is this happening? Well, it's because radiation gives you acne. That's not a joke. Radiation gives you acne. Radiation, which they put the power lines in poor neighborhoods on purpose, the people in those neighborhoods are feeling super high amounts of radiation every day. And guess what they have? A special disease that covers your body in acne. So the reason I don't listen to music anymore is because it doesn't do anything. It has no purpose. Unless it's positive. But you should listen to something that's going to change you genetically. That's going to change your skill set. It's going to change your mindset. Subliminals. TV are all negative subliminals that do nothing for you. You make money You know, they make money off your ass when you watch television. Just when I walk into the living room, because my grandparents are loaded with subliminal messages, they watch Hallmark Channel so much. And it's drastically increased from when I was a kid. They would show five commercials when I was a kid, maybe even three. Then they'd get back to the show. When I go in there just to say hi or talk, yeah, the lights just did that when I hit them. weird coincidence. I'll go in there, there'll be 15 commercials playing before the show actually, and you'll forget what you're actually watching. You'd be so brainwashed with these commercials. There's a commercial for everything. Is your foot crooked? This product will fix it. Did you slightly cough in class? This will fix it. This product, there's no end to it. And you're allowing it in so easily. It's just a harmless commercial, right? Everything you see on TV, you remember. Everything you hear in a song, you remember if you see it over and over and over and over again. That's why the companies who have the most money can play commercials over and over and over again. That is literally one of the best ways of marketing yourself. You use your money that you earn with your shitty job, and you put it towards making your life better by advertising yourself. There's this douchey guy that's really irritating named Ty Lopez, and I've never met him in real life, so I don't personally know him. But what he did was, I want to call it a Trump-like thing. You constantly annoy people in certain ways, and you get attention from them. Then eventually people are gonna send how mean this person is, or how unfair, or how annoying. And what that's doing is that's making the person get free traffic. They are getting free views from you, and when you share it, because you don't like the person or you don't like the video, you're giving them more money. You aren't accomplishing anything complaining. You're staying in the same spot and never getting anywhere. So, you need to stop and see and say, wait, no, I shouldn't do that. That's going to make the problem worse, and it will escalate, and it won't get fixed in any way. Can't do that. I learned that throughout my whole life. This was vodka. Seriously. I'm gonna end this video here and just say, listen to what you want to listen to. I'm not telling you you have to listen to subliminals. I'm just saying they affect you in a positive way. You can also look up. I think there's a bug in here. You can also look up positive affirmations or positive inspirational motivational speeches. Those always help me. I like listening to those in the morning. Okay, yeah. End it here. Any questions, just ask them in the comments.